Okay, so we were discussing about the solutions in plant cell, that is isotonic, hypotonic and hypertonic. So in hypertonic, now cell is losing the water to the outer medium because inside water molecules are more. What happened is that what is the, you know, the structure, complete detailed structure of plant cell now. There are few changes takes place in exosmosis. A normal plant cell, you know that there is a vacuole and there is a nuclear membrane, there is a nucleus, right? So this, what will happen is exosmosis takes place means water is coming out from the cell. Is it clear? Yes, water is released, coming out. When this water is released, this water is released from the vacuole, or another other cellular contents are also released with it. So when you are taking out something from this area, what will be the result? It will be it will be change its size or become very less, like shrink. This vacuole will be now stretched to this much size, and the whole cytoplasm, now this area, this is filled with the cytoplasm. So once the inner side content will start coming outside, this cytoplasm will shift just to one side. So two things they are happening here. Vacuole size changes, it will just become it decreases in its size, and cytoplasm will just come towards one corner and become like a line like structure, or become very very thin, right? So this kind of structure or this kind of cell is called plasmolyzed cell. So what happens is that during exosmosis, content from the, or you can mention here that the cellular content means inside the cell, cellular content from the vacuole, they start coming out. Due to this, vacuole shrinks, right? So this is shrink, vacuole will shrink, and cytoplasm, it will detach, it will come at one corner. So cytoplasm is arranged at one corner or one side. This cell is called plasmolyzed cell, and process is called plasmolysis. So what is plasmolysis? When the inner content of cell will start coming out or oozes out from the vacuole, it becomes shrink or decrease in its size, and cytoplasm also detached and come at one side, right? When plasmolyzed cell, this cell, now you are taking this cell which has shrinked vacuole and the cytoplasm at one side, when you are going to place it in fresh water. Now I have taken this cell, I have placed it again in a pure water or fresh water or a hypotonic solution. What will happen? It will regain its original position, and this cell is called deplasmolyzed cell, or process is called deplasmolysis. So when plasmolyzed cell, it is placed in hypotonic solution or fresh water, it regain its water, it swell, it start absorbing the water, come back to its normal situation, or again regain its normal shape, and the process is called deplasmolysis. So you can see clearly that this is a reversible process, means plasmolyzed cell can be change into a normal cell, and a normal cell can become the plasmolyzed cell. So that is why this process of plasmolysis to deplasmolysis is a reversible process. They can move in the both directions. Mean this is normal cell, this can be changed into the this condition, and this condition, if you are putting them into the normal water, fresh water, hypertonic solution, it can come back to its original position. So two terms again I'm telling you to, you need to know, is exosmosis and endosmosis. When water come out, moves out from the cell, it will become flaccid, egg beds become shrink, and endosmosis, when water moves inside the cell, it becomes swell, rigid or turgid, right? So this is all about the, you need to know about the osmosis, clear? Next, let's talk about the imbibition. Now, before I talk about imbibition in detail, few things I have written in a very normal sentences so that I can make you understand, or I can help you to understand that what is actually happening in imbibition. So these terms, before we go into detail, you all of you need to know about imbibition. So what is imbibition? It is a type of diffusion. What if I ask you what is osmosis? It is a type of diffusion. The only thing is, in diffusion we talk about the substances, we talk about the solute, but in imbibition and osmosis we talk about the water molecules. So it is a type of diffusion where water is adsorbed, right? Now I am going to use this word very frequently in this process, adsorbed by the solid particles without forming a solution, which result in increase in volume. So before I jump into the detail, for you important, you have heard word both absorption and adsorption. There is a difference, adsorption and absorption. Absorption is a simple process in which basically what happened is that all the atoms, ions or molecules of a fluid, they are that is dissolved by the liquid or solid substance. Wherever they will move continuously, either it's a solid surface or it is a liquid in a container, when they move, they are absorbed by them, right? But what is adsorption? When atoms, ions or molecules, either from the solid, liquid or gas, they do not move completely inside the material or the solution. They only stick to the surface. So they, if this is your area where a process of imbibition has to happen, then these water molecules, they come on the surface, their kinetic energy, they will change their energy into another state, and then the process of imbibition will takes place. So the process of imbibition occurs on the surface. Absorption is simply absorption of molecules of a fluid in a particular solution. Here solution is formed. But in adsorption, they do not form any solution. They only stick to the surface. What is going to stick to the surface? Water molecules. If suppose we randomly take example of water molecules. Water molecules, if it has to move, suppose you have given water to a plant, what are you expecting? Water will move from roots to the stem. That is absorption, right? Absorption of water. But if I talking about the adsorption, like the raisins, if you have soak your raisins in the water, what is, after few hours you will observe that raisins, they will increase their size. That process is adsorption. Now there is not water molecule is moving to each and every raisin. No, they just stick to the surface, and that process is called adsorption. So it is a type of diffusion where water is adsorbed on the surface by adsorbed by solid particles there without forming a solution. That is important for you to understand, that there is no solution is formed. So when there is no solution formed, it result in increase in volume. What is actually I'm trying to say is, like, suppose you have taken a beaker, there is a water, and you have put the dry seeds, completely dried seeds in that water. What will you observe after some few hours? That these seeds are swollen. It means the water has stick to the surface of these seeds, but it has not dissolved into the seeds. There is no solution which is getting formed. These dry seeds, they are just taking water on their surfaces, and there is increase in volume. Or in another words, means if is there any solution is forming here? We are forming, no, we have just taken a simple water and dry seeds. What dry seeds have done? They have taken the water molecules on their surface and increased their sizes without forming a solution. But it is a movement of water molecule, so water is adsorbed by solid particles. You can correlate these particles as a dry seeds without forming a solution, with result in increase in volume. Whenever you are going to read this definition, just look at this diagram, you will be clear with your concept that what is the meaning of this definition. Now, few terms are there. Imbibents, because we are talking about the process imbibition, so there are imbibents and imbibate. Solid substances, or basically if I say adsorbent, which take part in imbibition. So what is the imbibent here? Dry seeds. These are the solid substances and these are going to adsorb water. So solid substances which take part in imbibition. What is imbibate? Water. It is that liquid which is imbibed. It is known as imbibed. It is known as imbibate. So liquid is imbibate and dry seeds are imbibent. So what is actually adsorption? Imbibents means when solid substances or your dry seeds, they hold the imbibate. For your understanding, I can just write down in brackets so that you can correlate it, that dry seeds, they hold the water by adsorption. Means with the help, it is a force which help to hold two substances together. So when dry seeds, they hold the water, they swell, they increase their volume, the process is called the adsorption. Basically the process is imbibition, but it takes place through the adsorption, not absorption. It takes place through the adsorption. Now let's move to the main things which are mentioned in our NCERT about the imbibition. So here, what is happening in imbibition? That water or solvent is adsorbed. There are few changes when water is adsorbed, few changes during this process. Imbibition pressure, then there is heat is generated, volume is increases. So those points I'm going to take in detail in my next video.